Nothing in the ocean is as simple as it looks if you account for the biological complexity on it. The challenge we are trying to solve is how to observe microscale dynamics of either a single cell or a multicellular organism that has the capacity to traverse extremely long or infinite distances on the vertical axis.
You can think of the ocean as a seemingly endless column of water, right? And the question is, how do you bring an endless column of water to the lab?
We had been thinking about this problem almost for a couple years, and then one time, sitting in my office, we were just doodling on ideas, and then it dawned upon us a very simple insight. It's a very simple insight, is the fact that what if the two ends of the tube were connected? And as the organism moves down, you spin the wheel up. And as the organism moves up, you spin the wheel down. So it's an infinite chamber. And in the frame of reference of the lab, the organism doesn't go anywhere, but in its own frame of reference, it's actually moving. And that's the first time we drew it on the whiteboard.
We took like a flexible tube, put it on like a circular like bicycle tire, and we literally were rotating it with our hands to see if the idea works.
So the gravity machine that people see now versus the gravity machine that existed early on are dramatically different.
It's kind of like a intelligent microscope, right? So it knows where to look for the organism based on what the organism is doing.
That evolution is quite beautiful because the current version, we can literally take this machine on a research vessel which is wobbling, you know, 10 degrees back and forth, and it's hard for us to stand while this machine is tracking a single organism. We are trying to engage the biological community to understand and appreciate the role of gravity on life on this planet. If you look at the role of life in the ocean and carbon sequestration, all the way to thinking about patterns of migration, vertical migrations that occur actively. And finally, at the broadest scale, what are the fundamental sensory inputs that a cell in the ocean is taking in to make decisions? What often enough that we joke in the lab is the most powerful way of unraveling these mysteries is just by watching. And as the conditions on this planet change with acidity, with the temperature of the ocean, how do these sets of fundamental processes change over time? Our goal with this work has been, is how do we bring all aspects of the ocean to a lab setting? And how do we bring lab-based observational and microscopy tools to the ocean? Because this is such a multifaceted project, there is biology, there is physics, there is engineering, there is field work. This has only been possible because of the diversity of people in our lab. We think quite a lot about putting ourselves in field context. Every field trip has taught us new things and it has brought new problems to the table. You have to be one with the problem that you're trying to study. The way that we have built and designed this instrument is soon enough, anybody will be able to take their regular microscopes that they have, flip them 90 degrees, and mount this stage that performs this type of an operation to turn a traditional microscope into what we call a gravity machine.